8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Existential threats. The doomsday clock being set, the closest it's ever been to midnight, a scientific kind of metaphor for the apocalypse or end of humanity or life on this planet as we know it. It's our duty to see hope and humor as a positive force that can enact change.
Vi er med til prøve på Før vi forsvinder, et stykke nyt scenekunst, som ensemblet bag selv kalder en tragisk performance, og menneskets selvdestruktive og transformative kraft.
You will meet a Danish man who's going through a bit of an existential crisis at the moment in terms of thinking about his own existence and the existence of humanity and life on the planet through a mix of physical theater and New Circus and something that is hopefully a bit thought-provoking and touching, but also has a bit of humor and wildness to it.
Det internationale scenekunstensemble Out of Balance, der til daglig har base i København, arbejder lige nu hos nycirkusfolket Dynamo på Odense Havn.
Efter at have opdaget underjordiske energireserver, begynder mennesker at ændre atmosfærens sammensætning. Dette ændrer igen klimaet og oceanernes kemi.
Og den nye forestilling, Før vi forsvinder, er tydeligt inspireret af de igangværende klimaforandringer.
This was the height of the Cold War.
Men også andre menneskeskabte kriser, der med årtiers mellemrum skaber en stemning af dommedag kloden over.
And the darkened cup drifts.
The motivation came from the fact that I gave birth and had my first child, and was thinking about the future, basically, on a larger scale, and that coincided with a real global push and awareness in terms of climate change, primarily, but then a lot of books and things I was reading about the sixth extinction and life on this planet and the human impact on life on this planet, and that we were at this tipping point, with also the doomsday clock being set, the closest it's ever been to midnight, which is a scientific kind of metaphor for the apocalypse or end of humanity or life on this planet as we know it. So all these things are going on, and I had my newborn baby and was thinking, how do we deal with all this? And this kind of drive for love and life and to live on in the face of these obstacles and existential threats and just the heaviness of it at the moment. Things felt really hard, kind of, to think about the future, his future, our future.
Allerede i 1970'erne begyndte frøer langsomt at forsvinde fra verdens floder, sumpe og skove.
Fortæller instruktør Katrina Bugaj. Der også har ville skabe en forestilling, hvor man kunne finde en slags optimisme, før vi forsvinder.
We need hope. We need hope and to believe that we can, that there's still time. We're not there yet. It's not midnight yet. And as people, it's our duty to see hope and humor as a positive force that can enact change in us and individually, but also on a larger scale. So it really is about hope in the end.
We're on a road to nowhere. Come on inside.
Før vi forsvinder, kan opleves i levende live hos Dynamo på Odense Havn. Torsdag, fredag og lørdag, 1. til 3. oktober.
This is a moment in time where we've been so separated from each other and in our own bubbles because we've had to be with the pandemic and everything. And now it's a time, as things are possible, to come together again, to come together and to experience a world that will bring us from this moment of doubt and apartness that we've been in to a place of hope and togetherness.